Namaste friends, welcome to Art and Talent. It's because of love only we are here. It's because of love only that whatever you see around is running and in place. Deep inside, the only reason why we are here is just because of love. And the things what we do is just because of love. So with this, I want to talk about today's card. And that is the card of the lovers. तो दोस्तों आज हम बात करेंगे the card of the lovers की, लेकिन उससे पहले इसके keywords में जाएंगे. इसके keywords हैं love, harmony, relationship, blessings, being together, starting a new journey. So six number जो है numerology के point of view से it's a card of love, relationship, being together, emotions, that is what the six signify here. And it is also the card of the lovers, which is also number six. This card attracts beauty, love, relationship. It's a merge of male and female energies together. This is the most desirable card which everyone wants to experience. The card of lovers is a very magical and a beautiful card. You can actually somehow connect this card to the Bible story of the Adam and Eve. दोस्तों ये कार्ड इतना स्पेशल है क्योंकि इसके अंदर जो है पूरे जो है एक तो लाइफ का मैसेज आ जाता है और इसको कार्ड जो है हम इसको बाइबल के साथ जोड़ते हैं. अगर आप ध्यान से देखेंगे तो ये एडम और ईव की कहानी है. एडम और ईव की कहानी है क्योंकि this is their first experience, this is their first intimacy together, this is their experience of being together, knowing each other and going into a totally different realm which they have not lived. Isse pehle ab tak jo the lovers alag alag the. Man was a different and woman was different, like the masculine and the female principle, they were not together. But in this card, they are merging together. They are sinking together. Finally, the yin and yang is like merging together. They are being together. The card of lovers में ये जो हम figures देखते हैं ये और कोई नहीं, ये figure of empress and emperor है. This is the same figure what we saw in the card of empress and the emperor. And if we see the series, they got together, they got married, the hierophant got them married and the relationship started and finally it came down to the card of lovers. And this is the first time they are meeting together, they are knowing each other, they are merging with each other. So hum kya dekhte hain yahan pe jo male jo figure hai, he is like full of awe, he is like full of wonder and उसका सारा फोकस जो है अगर हम देखें तो वो इट्स जस्ट टोटली ऑन द वुमन. एंड वुमन इज लाइक सो मैग्नेटिकली यू नो लाइक शी इज इनवाइटिंग दिस मैन, शी इज जस्ट ओपन एंड शी इज इनवाइटिंग एंड शी इज जस्ट रेडी टू गो अहेड विद दिस यूनियन. सो इट्स अ वेरी मैजिकल काइंड ऑफ एन एक्सपीरियंस विच इज हैपनिंग इन दिस कार्ड. अगर हम देखें इस वुमन के पीछे जो है एक देर इज एन एप्पल ट्री विच इज शोन और एक स्नेक जो है उसके कान में जो है कुछ फुसफुसा रहा है जिसको सुन के जो है ये जो फीमेल फिगर है वो मुस्कुरा रही है. क्या कह रहा है वो स्नेक? दैट स्नेक इज कॉलिंग, दैट स्नेक इज सेइंग यू नो दैट यू आर स्पेशल, दैट यू हैव बीन चूजन, यू हैव बीन चूजन फॉर दिस ब्यूटिफुल मोमेंट, this you have been chosen for this magical moment and not everyone gets this chance. So this is what she is so happy about. To agar hum figure ko dekhe to like her focus is like towards the angel, she is looking at the angel. Baat main jo kehna cha raha hu wo ye hai ki when a woman becomes a total woman, when there is no aspect of male in her, then she becomes nothing but a magnet to attract everything which is around her. और यहाँ पे हम देखते हैं कि लाइक शी हैज़ बिकम अ मैग्नेट एंड शी इज़ अट्रैक्टिंग दिस मैन, और वो मैन जो है वो लाइक अगर आप उसका एक्सप्रेशन देखेंगे और अगर उसको देखेंगे लाइक शी इज ही इज़ जस्ट गेटिंग अट्रैक्टेड टू हर एंड ही इज़ जस्ट लुकिंग एट हर एंड नो वन एल्स, उसको फोकस ही नहीं हो पा रहा, वो देख भी नहीं पा रहा कि देर इज़ एन एंजल विच इज़ अबव हु इज़ ब्लेसिंग बोथ ऑफ देम। लेकिन इस केस में हम क्या देखते हैं कि ओनली द वुमन इज़ एबल टू टेक द ब्लेसिंग एंड द मेल गेट्स इग्नोर्ड, यू नो लाइक मेल इज़ नॉट एबल टू सी यू नो दैट देर इज़ अ फिगर हु इज़ ब्लेसिंग बोथ ऑफ देम। सो अगर हम मेल फिगर के पीछे देखें तो देर आर लाइक 12 फ्लावर्स यू कैन से, और लाइक द 12 पेटल्स, 12 लीव्स यू कैन से, एंड दीज स्टैंड फॉर 12 एस्ट्रोलॉजिकल साइंस, एंड दिस ऑल्सो स्टैंड फॉर ऑल द कम्प्लीट साइकिल। द माउंटेन बिहाइंड स्टैंड फॉर एक्सटेसी एंड ऑर्गाज्म, दिस इज द पार्ट वेयर द सेक्शुअल इंटीमेसी इज हैपनिंग बिटवीन दीज टू कपल। सो अ ब्यूटिफुल रिलेशनशिप इज अबाउट टू स्टार्ट, और अ ब्यूटिफुल इंटीमेट काइंड ऑफ अ सेक्शुअल यूनियन इज अबाउट टू स्टार्ट, एंड दैट इज वॉट इट इज पॉइंटिंग टूवर्ड्स। दैट माउंटेन इज द पीक ऑफ ऑर्गाज्म, दैट माउंटेन इज द पीक ऑफ इंटीमेसी ऑफ बींग टूगेदर ऑफ दिस मेल एंड फीमेल। सो द कार्ड ऑफ लवर्स इज समथिंग विच इज लाइक सो कॉमन इन द सेंस लाइक सो नेचुरली यू नो इट इन्वाइट्स पीपल, इट यू नो पीपल गेट अट्रैक्टेड टू दिस कार्ड वेरी इजिली, और अपने आप में कार्ड की जो ऊर्जा है वो इट्स लाइक इट्स एक्चुअली वेरी मैजिकल, इट्स वेरी ब्यूटिफुल, इट्स अ काइंड ऑफ अ फर्स्ट एक्सपीरियंस विच वन यू नो गोज थ्रू। आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द फर्स्ट टाइम यू नो लाइक वेन यू स्टार्ट एक्सपीरियंसिंग द इंटीमेसी विद अ वुमन और अ मैन, द फर्स्ट किस, द फर्स्ट फीलिंग ऑफ ऑर्गास्म विच यू गो थ्रू, it appears to be so magical, it appears to be like everything is like so colorful. That is what this card is pointing towards. But the only thing is what I want to say is like this card is a very natural phenomena of nature which is happening. So this is more of a chemical reaction between a man and woman. The consciousness is missing for sure, because you know there is an animal aspect which is inside of us. I call it animal because there is nothing degrading in it, but when we talk about sex, sex is something you know which comes from the animal kingdom, and the more you become conscious, the more your consciousness grows, the sex starts disappearing from your life, you start becoming more and more deeper into your own self. That ecstasy, that orgasm, which was happening on the outside, that starts happening inside of you. And in fact, the ecstasy and orgasm, which you experience on the outside with a partner, that is temporary. That is something which is not going to stay. And just because of that experience, we get indulged, we get so much addicted to sex and to the other, because we feel you know like it is such a deep addiction, because it was such a beautiful feeling, because for the first time you know like your ego disappeared when in the moments of deep sex, in the moment of orgasm, you simply just disappear, you're not there, it's just a magical feeling which is happening. And every one of us wants to be in that peak as long as possible. But the law of the nature is such that you can't be there on the physical level. But yes, it is possible on a spiritual level that you can actually attain that state of spirituality, of that intimacy, where you can be in orgasm, be in union of yin and yang inside of you all the time. दिस इज समथिंग विच एवरी वन ऑफ यू डिजर्व्स, दिस इज समथिंग विच एवरी वन इज केपेबल ऑफ. सो डोंट थिंक दैट दिस इज ओनली पॉसिबल फॉर बुद्धा और रामा और कृष्णा और ओशो और सदगुरु. दिस इज समथिंग विच इज पॉसिबल फॉर ईच वन ऑफ अस. And one actually needs to experience, one actually needs to, you know, go through this experience. Because every one of you deserves it. Every one of you deserves a beautiful life. And the more you know the art of living, the more you will be deeper inside your own self. And you will experience love, you will experience God, you will experience ecstasy. And you will be in orgasm all the time. And then you will not be addicted, then you will not be bounded by the sex which is outside. Then the sex is something, it just becomes a tool. It is something which you are control of. Earlier sex was controlling you. But now you have a choice for the first time that you can choose to be in sex or not. Whether you want to go into it or not. Earlier it is more of a push. Earlier it is more of a blind chemical reaction which is happening inside of you and things are just happening unconsciously. But the more on the conscious level you move, the more you will see that sex will disappear and something more of an intelligent nature will happen. The thing is, the sexual experience in itself is so beautiful. And that is the benchmark, that is what the ecstasy, the orgasm which every one of us is looking for. That is something for which we live. That is for something, you know, which we are alive. The yoga and the meditation and the tantra give you those options. Make you ready, prepare your body and mind for that union of that male and female which is sitting inside of you to happen. So this card of the lovers is nothing but just a glimpse of Adam and Eve having this contact for the first time and experiencing sex, experiencing intimacy. And the blessing is given by the angel, because angel approves of the union. And the angel is nothing but the symbolism of nature here, which is blessing them, which is making them together. And the male and the female principle, when they are together, the magic starts happening. And as I said, remember, the magic outside, when it happens, it's very temporary. But when this magic is happening inside of you, then it never ends, it's everlasting. And that is why, you know, like we call Shiva as Ardh Nareshwar, where the Shiva and Parvati, they become one. And that Ardh Nareshwar is in every one of us. Jab aap Shiv ho sakte hain, jab aap Ardh Nareshwar ho sakte hain, to itne chote pe kyun rukna? When you can become God yourself, when you have this potential of God inside of you, why do you have to stop yourself? So, the card of lovers is nothing but a glimpse of love, intimacy, relationship. Jab bhi ye card aapki reading mein aaye, that shows that something of a loving nature is happening around. That you are getting attracted to someone, or someone is getting attracted to you, or you are in a relationship with someone and you want to go ahead and make a family with this person, or it could just be a pure sexual attraction with someone. That is what the card of lovers is pointing towards. And before going, I would like to read something, you know, which came out of this card while I was thinking of, you know, speaking with you today. And here it goes. two kids, body grown, in wonder, in surprise. Just passion and attraction. What is it? Where does this lead? The angel blesses them and approves of their union, allowing them to merge and experience God. The ecstasy. Where does it lead? Someone asked. And someone said, be quiet and experience the rainbow on the bubble. Witness and you will be given ultimate freedom. Love. So this was something which popped out when I was looking at the picture of the card of the lovers. It's a beautiful card of union between male and female figure. I just wish that this love, beautiful relationship, ecstasy and orgasm, every one of you should be able to experience it. And with this note, I would like to end my interpretation for the card of lovers today. I hope you enjoyed the reading. And I'm sorry if anyone is hurt because of if I said something. There is no intention of hurting anyone, anyone's sentiments. And friends, take care till then. I will see you in my next one. Enjoy yourself. Namaste.